What's good, everybody? I'm doing this video because I just had a quick thought while I was on my computer, and I was supposed to have made a video, a review video, right after I saw the movie, but I decided I wasn't gonna do it. I ran across. I ran across an article on the internet that it had nothing to do with what I'm going to talk about in this video, but it just made me think about the conversation that me and my coworker had a few days ago. And I was going to make this video after me and him talked about it, but it slipped my mind because I had other things to do, other videos to make. But you know, now is there's no greater time than the present, right? So, so the question that you know, that I'm about to ask, you know, stems from that conversation that me and my coworker had. He said that he had saw a video on here where there was someone giving a review of the movie, and they said that the Beast was a representation of the Baphomet, or was the Baphomet? And that's the question that I'm raising in this video. Do you think that the Baphomet, or do you think that the Beast represented the Baphomet? Now, my personal opinion on that sentiment is that Walt Disney doesn't really just put things out in the open. They always hide things in their cartoons, in their drawings, in their advertisements. So I think that if this claim was made after the person watched the movie, I think that it's a claim that should have been made when they were showing the preview, when they were showing previews of the movie. They said that in the cartoon that the beast had no horns, and I think that that is the entire basis of their argument. And I'm pulling up the Beast now and looking at the pictures. The Beast indeed had horns. The Beast indeed had horns, but I don't want to bring any kind of doubt to that person's claim. I think that it is something that's worth looking into, but it's not. It's not something that I myself think is an accurate claim, just based on the simple fact that Disney likes to hide things. I don't think that they would put something like the Baphomet in their cartoons. But you know, it's I don't know. Just looking at these pictures, making sure. I might as well pull the Baphomet up while I'm then there's a question of what is the Beast actually? You know, which is a very interesting question. You know, you look at the head of the Baphomet and you look at the head of the Beast, it is almost the same. But I don't know. But that could be any animal. That could be a ram. It could be a deer. You know, because they not only have horns, they have ears as well. Well, the way that the head is built, the head of those animals are built the exact same way. But no one really understands the and here's something. I'm looking at a picture of the Baphomet, and they're saying that the Baphomet head could represent the female reproduction system. So does that make women a form of the devil, or some kind of a representation of the Baphomet? No. See, these type of claims need metaphysical research. No one who's a Christian should be making these claims, because if any Christian makes these claims, they should actually begin with doing the research of the very rituals that they hold in their own churches. A lot of the rituals that they perform in their churches come straight from other cultures. The way that other cultures worship their deities. Okay, now, the Baphomet was referred to in the female sexist video about the Quaggla, which was an operation which was performed in the movie Get Out. And I'm gonna leave a link to that video in the description box where you could see what she's saying, but how that movie never did show the Baphomet, but it still made reference to the Baphomet. I'm just saying this to show how Disney would be a little bit more careful than saying, let's make the beast look like the Baphomet. Just doing a quick search on the Baphomet in the Beauty and the Beast, and there is there are a few pictures, you know, talking about it, you know, just doing a picture search. But my thing is, if this was the case, why are they just now why are they just now making reference to that? Where the beast, since 1991, I believe it was, that the Beauty and the Beast came out. Why are they just now making this claim? You know, this claim was supposed to have been made years ago when they saw it. But I don't know. I don't know if it's because they were a Christian that they made this claim, or if it's because they actually did their research and they found something saying that that the beast in Beauty and the Beast was indeed the Baphomet. But until then, you know, you can't I don't think that you sustain the children's experience by making claims without research. Yes, indeed, it is something worth looking at, but let's not stain the children's experience. You know, we as parents, you know, we grew up, you know, around that time. You know, we were teenagers, you know, adolescent around that time. You know, but you know, we grew into this knowledge, you know, knowing what the Baphomet is and this, that, and third. But you know, we, you know, I think if it was a problem, it wouldn't be the number one movie in the world. Of course, you have a lot of those who are ignorant, but those of us knowing what the what the beast represents, or what they're claiming the beast represents. You know, I don't know. Guess it's okay. I don't know. It is something worth looking into, though. I won't take that away from it. So, you know, let me know what you guys think. Do you think that the beast, you know, and if you think that it does, tell me why. Don't just say it does. You know, tell me why, what research you've done to come to that conclusion. Not just what he looks like. That's like looking at a homeless person and saying, oh, he put himself in this situation. You know, just because one, you know, person makes it bad for the rest doesn't actually mean that that's what that person, you know. Don't judge things by their appearance. Matter of fact, I'm glad that I said that. There was a scene in this movie where the candlestick told Belle, which is played by Emma Watson, you know, forgive us for our first impression. Okay. But, you know, first impression is also, you know, don't judge me by my appearance. You know, so I believe that that's what this movie was also saying. Don't judge me based on my appearance. That if you think that the beast is what you think it is, you're wrong. And if you really just pay attention to the movie, a lot of the codes are in the dialogue. I wasn't able to see anything, in the snow or in the tile on the floor or in the walls or even in the dishes themselves. You know, I just wasn't able to see it. I probably have to watch it again to make that, yeah, let me know what you guys think. You know, give me a reason why you think it is, or if it's not, you know, give me a reason why it's not. You know, the whole purpose of this video is just for us to do collective thinking, you know, to come to a common understanding, I guess, of what we're looking at, because, you know, this all plays a part in whether or not, you know, some of us buy the DVD or the Blu-ray whenever it comes out. But, you know, overall, you know, like I said in the other video, I believe that it's a good movie. It was a good movie, and you know, I'm willing to, you know, buy it on Blu-ray whenever it comes out. But yeah, you know, like, share, subscribe, and I'll see you guys in this video. Peace.